I want to know what you did yesterday, and now I want to know what you're going to do today.
Well, Andrew, first of all,
short term of me, I know.
Yes, we're not.
You're doing stuff.
We're out there investing in the markets, but we're not trading day to day. I mean, we're doing. Look what I've been on with all of you this year, right? And I've been talking about how the fundamentals have been consistently slowing. And as the fundamentals have been consistently slowing, we've been taking down the risk profiles of our portfolios and investing in the more defensive, higher quality sectors of the economy. And those are the sectors, absolutely, as Dom pointed out, that are working. So this is exactly why, because this year, there have been three hopes for the Fed. There's been a hope trade going on. It's been the Fed, it's been that earnings will bottom, and it's been that the trade resolution will get, the trade talks will get resolved. Well, those three things are not coming through, and that hope trade's starting to fizzle. I think that's the ultimate story, because just think about, I mean, you've had the Fed and trade been the big distraction over the last 3 or 4 months. Now you're forced to focus back on the fundamentals. Just look at, we're almost done with second quarter earnings season. This is like the third or fourth consecutive quarter of deceleration, and it's not just like slower positive. If you look at the components, the cyclical sectors, all negative earnings year over year. So this is what we're talking about, and this is looking like it's going to continue into the back half of the year, because look at what the guidance is coming. The guidance that you're seeing this earnings season is probably some of the worst you've seen since coming out of that 2016.
You said that last quarter, too, and we beat it.
Well, no, this guidance is worse than last quarter. Yes, so what you're talking about has companies for the last 10 years have been training the Wall Street to sort of lower those expectations into earnings season so that it can beat.
Where are you guys for this quarter? Negative earnings this quarter?
So we think that the way that most of Wall Street looks at it, which is a little different than us, is like it's coming in about flat year over year, which is almost a perfect copy of what you saw the last quarter, probably what you're going to see in the third quarter. But as this has happening, you've had zero earnings growth, and now you put on additional headwinds to growth, and the hopes that were the market was relying on, whether it was the Fed coming in on a shiny white horse or trade resolution, those things are less likely. So I think
we have a headline. I just want to bring in a headline. Sure. Yeah, this is partly probably why we're seeing a lift in the futures this morning. China's PBOC, the Central Bank of China, tells foreign firms the yuan will not keep falling. So it seems like China is coming in saying, you know what, the currency won't keep falling.
Sounds like they're manipulating.
So, but then who blinked here? I mean, is that China blinked? China?
This is in their interest. So the narrative was completely wrong yesterday. China doesn't want to devalue the currency. This was just about a simple poke in the eye to let us know they have other tools.
This is
good for China, for the currency.
Absolutely. It's hard to argue that this is anything other than natural market forces. When you put tariffs on Chinese imports, that currency is going to tend to go down. And the manipulation that Kevin's talking about is actually holding it up, which by IMF rules is not manipulation. IMF
as it
states.
It has for years. It's seven. Seven's the number.
Yes, but so the IMF, to be an official currency manipulator, it means you have to be stepping in to lower the value of your currency, not to raise it. So I think that that's why, when we just got our latest report from the Treasury that said, when they investigated this, they would not call China a currency.
Yesterday's sell-off down 900 points at the lows on the Dow, that was driven by fears of a currency war. We have the PBOC this morning now saying that the yuan will not keep falling. Does that take off the table that concern of the currency war? And does that, therefore, make yesterday's sell-off completely overdone? And maybe we reverse a lot of that today.
Well, I think there's two different dynamics going on. I think it was the market reading into it being a currency war was overdone. At most, you're going to get a currency schoolyard fight. I mean, it's like little moves. They're not going to, they have very little interest in massively devaluing their currency. What happens if they do that? You're going to see massive capital outflows, and they don't want to see that either. So I think that, directionally, if you just pull up the long-term chart for the Chinese yuan, it's been coming down for the last 10, 20, 30 years. I don't think that this changes that story. So
does
I think
this
that
change your allocation to U.S. domestic equities in any way?
We have been, yeah,
where
absolutely.
Where are you going, cash?
So we've raised some cash, but we've been lowering consistently our U.S. equity exposure, and we've been moving abroad. So we had zero weight in Europe, as an example, last year. We've now neutralized that. We're roughly equal weight. China, we actually think, is a good risk-reward play, because just look at the actual underlying data. There's trade talks, and then the underlying data for China is actually starting to improve, at least on a relative basis, relative to everywhere else in the world where it's getting worse on a daily basis. So we think that China is probably a best risk-reward bet, given that no one wants to touch that with a 10-foot pole.